It's the Gator Man Show, only on 104.7.
Hey, I got Tell Faulkner in here. What's going on, buddy?
Hey, what's up, man?
There you are. I'm checking your levels here. We're winging it. We don't know what we're doing. We're just pushing buttons till it works. Tell reached out to me, I don't know, a week and a half, 2 weeks ago, and said, hey, man, I really love what you're doing. I'm a fan of radio. I'm on the road all the time. I like your show. I like how you're locally minded.
Right.
And you said all the right things. You sugared me up real good.
Well, I am. I'm a big fan of your show, man. I'm a big fan of what you're doing here and for, you know, the local events and everything. It's kind of, I'm a big fan of radio in general because, you know, it's kind of the staple for especially smaller communities like ours, right? And it kind of keeps everybody in touch with the local events and, you know, what's going on in the community.
Well, that's kind of what we're going to talk about today. It's not very local, but you're local.
I'm local.
And that's good enough for me. You're a fighter, man. Is that you're like the real deal?
Yeah, you know, I've been doing it a long time.
MMA,
MMA, kickboxing.
That's mixed martial arts,
right? Mixed martial arts is a mixture of all of it. You know, like I said, I started when I was 18. I'm 32 years old now. Got over 50 fights all together, mixed with kickboxing and MMA. Started when I was 18 and. Here we are today.
How do you get started in that? What do you just did you have, were you an angry kid?
I would probably say so.
you seem like a really nice guy.
Well, MMA really helped me a lot with that. It's funny that you say that because I think it kind of did bring out the better side of me through, you know, not so much discipline but
self control
and aging too, just getting older. It had something to do with it, but I think, you know, as an athlete in high school and just looking for something to compete in, and it just all kind of molded together. And like I said, I'm blessed to have the opportunity to still do what I do today.
Where'd you go to high school?
ACCS.
And what was your sport of choice?
I played football all throughout, ever since I went there, yeah.
But what position?
I played fullback and defensive tackle my senior year.
Nice, yeah. Nice. So when did you graduate? I'm drilling you here.
Yeah, 2007, dating me, man.
Nice.
It doesn't feel like that long.
I got more than a decade on you, buddy.
Oh, yeah?
So we're good. Well, we're good. Don't let the baby face fool you.
Right, yeah.
The Gators, Gators age slowly, man.
That's good.
Well, this is really great. You reached out, and you just had something coming up, and you thought it might be fun to talk about.
Yeah.
And you saw me giving some love to some other events. And,
right.
Man, I think this is a wonderful idea. You've got a big event coming up in Biloxi.
Right. It's April 11th in Biloxi at the IP Casino. And really, which probably can touch to more of the fans, you know, that's we're able to hear us today, there's one coming up the following weekend after that, April the 18th. In Marksville at the Paragon Casino, same promotion, Atlas Promotion. They put on a really good show. It's really entertaining, even if you're maybe not familiar with the fight game. But to go out and enjoy your time, I think it starts at 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, and it goes on all night. And then, you know, like I said, at Marksville especially, you're there. You got all kind of different things you can do throughout the night, too. So, really, me and my wife went to one back in October. And whenever they were talking about signing me, and we went, we really enjoyed ourselves. And I told them, yeah, man, just send me the contract. I'll sign it. And that's where we are right now. Mixed martial arts mixed with boxing, kickboxing, jiu-jitsu, Muay Thai.
You wanted to do this. You're looking for something to compete in after high school.
Uh-huh.
Did you just pick up the phone, call somebody?
One of my best friends, James Sweeney, actually brought me a flyer that said that they would be here in Natchez, and I just kind of picked it up from there, and that's really kind of how I got started on it. He picked up a flyer, you know, he said, like I said, maybe an angry kid or wasn't pointed in the right direction at the time, and that was just
I want to beat somebody up without getting in trouble for it.
Right. I got in trouble a lot for, you know, maybe doing things I shouldn't have been doing outside of the ring or cage as far as, you know.
Well, I don't want to paint the wrong picture of you, man.
Right,
you're like a really nice guy, and I've been following you on Facebook. You're a family man.
Yeah, I got three girls, my wife. You know, we live in Florence, and they're my world, man. And this is just something that, you know, that I love to do. At one point in my life, I was doing it to pay the bills. You know, I was fighting. That's why I have so many fights. I was fighting 2-3 times a month sometimes, just to keep, you know, the electricity on.
Is that time? Do you have time to heal like that, or you just have to go? You do it hurt sometimes,
right? You know, and I made a mistake back then too. I used to cut a lot of weight. To try to fight smaller guys.
What? Oh, lose weight. Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Lose weight to fight smaller guys, and really that was a rookie mistake, so to speak, on my part, because now, you know, obviously I'm a heavyweight.
Right.
Heavyweight, I focus on, you know, my speed, my endurance, my strength, and I've never lost a heavyweight fight. So,
wow.
Yeah. So.
And how long?
Back when I was 18, so like, I guess, 14 years now.
Man, congratulations. That's
thank
huge.
You. Yeah.
Now, you know, okay, speaking of your size,
mm-hmm.
Now, is this something you have to maintain, right? This
right.
is you burn a lot of calories doing what you, I'm sure, in training. So you have I was wondering about them. Yeah, I hear about, you know, these swimmers and these other athletes, they have to take in a lot of calories.
Right.
Because they're burning calories constantly.
Right. Well, like I said, I used to cut a lot of weight. Now I'm not really focused on that. I get to focus on more things. Half the battle back then would be just cutting the weight. I wouldn't even really be fight focused. Now I get to do all kind of my training. Like I said, I get to actually lift weights. You know, I couldn't lift weights back then because it would add on, you know, muscle, which is more weight. So now,
walk me through like a regular training day for you.
Well, it was really probably better throughout the week because I do okay. jiu-jitsu. Like I'll do Tuesday, tomorrow I'll go to jiu-jitsu and I'll do my jiu-jitsu.
What is
training.
Exactly? I know I've heard the word.
Right, that's on the ground, like
grappling,
submissions. Right, okay. Right, like trying to get you in a choke or turn your arm a certain way or something like that. And I'll more work on defense, you know. And that's really a blessing to me to have now at my disposal because I haven't always done that. Coming from a small town like this, we would really kind of just train ourselves. Where now I'm working with Gracie South in Jackson, and I really have that staple to add to my belt, you know, my arsenal. And like I said, it's just a huge blessing to have that. And I work, so I'll do that. I'll do Wednesday, I'll go to the gym, strength and conditioning. I'll do my strength and conditioning there, and I'll work out, I mean, maybe an hour or so, just whatever. I get tired and I'm sweating, you know.
Right.
And then I'll have you know, I still work down here in Natchez, so I have to drive a lot, and that's where I talk about my love for the radio comes in. But so after work, you know, I'll have my normal guys that I've always sparred with, which, you know, was just practicing boxing, basically mm-hmm. sparring. So I'll spar with my normal guys and really just focus on that because that's still my key way to win in fights is striking. That's why I moved to kickboxing, actually. And like I said, I just didn't have the opportunity to train at it. And now I do. So I really, you know, and training at it now, I mean, I'm not that bad at it. So, you know, I'm not really looking forward to being on the ground. But if it happens during the fight, of course, talking about April 11th, if it does go to the ground, it's not necessarily like it used to be when I was in MMA where it's like, well, this fight's over with. Now I actually have the opportunity and the know-how to get back up or
right.
at least hang on to the next round.
Do you still get really nervous or are you ever scared?
I was probably more nervous coming in here to talk to you today than I do before the fights. Like I said,
now that's just silly.
It's just a sport, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's the same kind of nerves you get in football, basketball,
sure.
baseball. And then whenever, you know, that first quarter or whatever, or first, whenever you're first getting into it, it goes away and it's just focusing on the game. And just like fighting, I'll just focus on the fight.
And I guess there's pretty good sportsmanship. There has
sure.
to be, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, man. Absolutely.
Respect for each other. And
yeah. Especially at this level on the regional circuit, you know, it's kind of like, of course, you're going in there to win every time, but you respect the guy because you know what goes into it, the training and the sacrifices that you have to make. And you could just have a different respect on a different level for somebody that puts in the same kind of work that you do.
Have you ever had to, like, hold back because you knew you were winning and you didn't want to hurt the guy?
No, I've never done that before.
Okay.
Or maybe you know, I like I said, I've had a good many fights, and most of my wins have been from knockout. And there's been a few times where the guy was completely out, and I didn't hit him because I knew it was over.
Okay, so you have like submissions, knockouts. Is there like a count out?
It's a TKO and decisions.
Okay.
So it's gonna. So what we're gonna do, April the 11th, we're gonna go 3 5-minute rounds. And if it goes all rounds, then it's going to be up to the decision of the judges. And that's how it goes. If I don't knock him out or if yep. he don't submit me.
Right.
And that's kind of how we both know going into it. This guy that I'm fighting, he's a brown belt in jiu-jitsu. So
who is your opponent?
Oh man, his name is Nunzio Camarato. He's like I said, Brazilian jiu-jitsu guy. So he's gonna be trying to take me down, and I know that. And I'm gonna be trying to knock him out, and he knows that.
Right.
So that's what kind of makes it interesting, you know.
You don't, there's yeah, you go in. It's
that's what I'm talking
game
about.
Game pace.
Right. That's what I'm talking about in the game plan too. Like I said, we're preparing me and my team right now for if it does go to the ground, get back up. You know what I'm saying? Get back up, get to the cage, and get back up, and then, you know, wear him out where our strikes can either, you know, potentially knock him out or win us a decision.
Now, is there somewhere this we can watch this, or do you have to be there with the ticket in the room?
It will be on a pay-per-view. I think they're just now starting to experiment with pay-per-views through internet.
Yeah, I'm looking into the old internet myself.
Right, yeah, so the old web. So I think it should be on, you know. I know you can get the link on atlasfights.com, and it'll tell you all that you need to know.
Well, I'm going to check this out, man, because now I've got somebody to root for.
Yeah, man. It's just something that the good Lord blessed me with, which he didn't bless me with a lot of things being good at, to be honest. You know, I can't, you know, change, you know, a motor out of a car or,
right.
You know, not even really. My wife would probably tell you that I'm not good with most stuff around the house as far as like plumbing and things like that.
Do one thing, man. Do one thing and try to do it better than anybody else. That's
right. You know, so he has blessed me with this, and I just feel like, you know, I'm thankful for the opportunity that the doors that it's opened, the people that have come into my life because of it. Yeah, I mean, it's just a huge blessing, and I still love to do it, so I'm still going to do it. And whenever I feel like I can anymore, then I won't.
Now, do you have fans? Is there a fan page? Or can people keep up with you anywhere or kind of keep up with our local guy and what's going on with you?
Really just, you know, my Snapchat or through my Facebook page is really, you can keep up with everything that I'm going through week to week.
Tel Faulkner?
Mm-hmm, Tel Faulkner.
T-E-L. Where'd you get that name? What is that?
I got that name from the Sacketts. You ever heard of the Sacketts?
Of course I have.
You know, Tell.
Okay.
That's where I got my name from.
I was named after Heath Barkley from the Big Valley. My middle name
is
Heath.
Right?
Yeah.
Wow.
We kids of the television.
Yeah. Western, man. That's where I got my name from. Tell, you know, like I said, that's just, I spell it different. It's T-E-L.
T-E-L.
Right. Just one L.
And Faulkner. I mean, that's
Faulkner.
Doesn't get any more Southern than that.
Right. You know, and my first name is actually William. I'm not kidding. It's William Tell Faulkner.
William Tell Faulkner.
WTF initials.
Well, I like that.
Yeah.
We were talking about like music. You come into different songs. You got just like in boxing,
yeah.
You know, there's you come in, kind of get you pumped up. What kind of music do you like to get pumped up to?
Well, see, that's...
You said some Johnny Cash.
Right, I did. I've walked out of Johnny Cash a few different times. I've walked out to Ring of Fire, Ain't No Grave. You're probably familiar with that. But see, I would walk out to all kind of different things. I'd walk out to, you know, I've even walked out to techno.
What?
You know? Yeah, seriously. I walked out to techno. I walked out to, you know, hip-hop. I've walked out to country. But what I've learned now is, you know, I'm not trying to get myself pumped up, you mm-hmm. know, to be the fight. I've already done the work, and now I'm just trying to stay calm. So, yeah, I walk out to Johnny Cash, man. I walk some.
I guess it kind of gets the crowd pumped, too.
Right.
Though.
It's more for them, if anything, right, because it is a show, and that's what we're talking about in entertainment industry. It's for the crowd, and it's for, you know, the people that paid the money to go see it, and that's what they like, to feel like they're part of it almost, you know, with the music and getting into it. So I might even have headphones in listening to a motivational speak, you know, walking to the cage and while the music's playing, something to get the crowd into the fight.
Okay, I found you a good a song you might want to use.
Okay.
This is a Gator Man recommendation.
I'm open to
it. Do you want to hang out for a few more minutes?
Sure,
or you need to get going?
Sure, no, I'm here. I got time.
All right, this is what I think you should come out to. And maybe I won't play the whole thing, but you'll see. I think you'll like this.
And I heard, as it were, the noise of thunder. One of the four beasts saying, "Come and see." And I saw, and behold, a white horse.
There's a man going round taking names, and he decides who to free and who to blame. Everybody won't be treated all the same. There'll be a golden ladder reaching down when the man comes around. The hairs on your arm will stand up at the terror in each sip and in each sup. Will you partake of that last offered cup or disappear into the potter's ground when the man comes around? Hear the trumpets, hear the pipers, 100 million angels singing. Multitudes are marching to the big kettle drum. Voices calling, voices crying. Some are born and some are dying. It's Alpha and Omega's kingdom come. And the whirlwind is in the thorn tree.
So what's like the Super Bowl or the World Series for you? What's the, is there a pinnacle that you're trying to reach? What's the?
Well, you know, at this point, obviously everybody knows the UFC. I was at the early point in my career trying to reach that stage. I have fought in Strikeforce, Bellator, which are right underneath it. I was very close to Glory Kickboxing, which was, that was going to be what me and my wife were really hoping for. We were waiting for a while there for a contract.
What is that? What is Glory Kickboxing?
It's the highest level of kickboxing.
Oh, okay.
And I was in Ring of Fire, which is, right? I know, right?
I know. Yeah, I got excited. Ring of Fire.
That was the promotion. Yeah, that's what I was in for the longest time. And, I was flying up north, taking fights there. And we just never got, like I said, I'm 11-0 in kickboxing and just never could get another contract. So that's why we're going back to MMA.
It's all right, man. Well, let's tell the dates one more time. The Biloxi event, that's when you're competing, is April 11th at the IP Casino in Biloxi.
Right.
And then April 18th, there's one going on in Marksville at the Paragon Casino. I'm going to share the playbills, I think. Is that what they're called?
Right.
Doesn't sound right for some reason.
Promotional posters.
Yeah, I'm going to share those on our page and on my page. And, man, please keep me updated on what's going on.
Absolutely.
Do you want to give your girls a shout out?
Yeah. Lissa Mae Aniston and my oldest Addie.
And
Daddy,
what about that
baby?
What about that wife?
Susanna Faulkner. Keep doing what you're doing.
Keep it up.
Thanks for putting up with me.
All right, man. Thank you so much.
Man, thank you.